Welcome back. Now then.
It's me, Rab. I need a wee word with you. Can I come in? Just you in here, eh, laddie? I was hoping to speak to your pals, too. Could you ask them to join us? It's Jade, the lassie I was fighting with in the tournament. She's missing. I've looked all over town, but she's nowhere to be found. I can't help but worry she's got herself caught up in something. Will you help an old man look for his wee friend? You're a star. With yourself and your pals here to help, I'm sure we'll find her in no time. Right, the last place anyone saw her was over by the orphanage. Let's start there, shall we?
Thank you. Victor.
Thank you.
How you like this?
How do you like this?
Thank you. easy.
Brought you a fresh one!
I won't be needing you to carry me any further, thanks.
So this is who's behind it all. Sir Hendrik must have missed one when he cleared the monsters out of town all those years ago.
Nicely done, lassie. I hope you'll forgive me, but we had a wee rummage around in your room, Vince. The liquid I found, that's what you drink before your fights, isn't it? What your friend here squeezes from the fighters he kidnapped.
That was you?
Perhaps not all humans are as stupid as our muscle-bound friend here. That's right, old man. Hendrik scarred me, but he did not kill me. The extract. It was the only way to regain my strength. So I had Vince bring me the choicest morsels. And why would he help me do such a thing, you ask? Because I offered to share the fruits of my labor, to give him strength beyond imagining. Who could refuse such a juicy offer, hmm?
I couldn't keep on winning forever. And if I wasn't winning, I wasn't bringing in the money we needed for the orphanage. Sorry, partner, but I can't let those kids down. Which means I can't let you and your friends leave.
Not now!
Oh, will you look at yourself, laddie? Do you not see what that stuff's doing to you? That foul fluid wasn't meant for human consumption. It's eating you from the inside out. It's a miracle you're still alive.
I guess cheaters never prosper, huh?
Spent at last, old friend. Such a shame. Then I suppose I'll have to deal with you myself.
Keep that thing busy. I'll see if I can get those people down.
You won't escape alive.
Take him!
We'll soon have that patched up.
Here!
Yeah!
I'll send you for supper!
And don't come back.
I had no choice. A third-rate fighter like me, I was never gonna make enough dough to keep the place open. So when I heard that voice, drifting up from down here, right beneath the orphanage, I listened. All I had to do was help him out, and he'd make me the toughest fighter around. Seemed like a pretty sweet deal. So I said sure. I wanted to win the tournament so bad, needed that money so bad, I let him use me. I knew it was wrong. But that orphanage, man, that's where I was raised. Those kids are my family. I had to do it. I had to.
So you let your desire to help the Bairns get the better of you. Well, there's certainly been greater evils done for less good. Tell you what, I'll have a word or two with the mayor. Don't worry, lad. We'll make sure the orphanage is looked after. So chin up, eh? Just don't let me catch you making deals with nasty beasts again. You hear?
Sir, I don't know what to say.
Right, I think that's all the time I'm going to have for this episode.
Wakey, wakey, little soldier.
Come on now, time to get up.
I said wake up!
Morning, darling!
Hate to drag you out of bed, but we need to head up to the arena. That prize they never got around to giving you? Well, they want to hand it over. Let's get moving before they change their mind.
If you're looking for me, I'll be in the cheap seats. And don't forget to give me a wave.
Up there next time. See you then.